Yes, I'm supposed to be getting together with my mother. Is she here yet?
Yes, she is. Right this way. Getting together with a lot of people today, aren't you?
What was that all about?
I'm not really sure. We ran into each other today at Landfair.
Oh, were you visiting Kevin Buchanan?
Yeah. His Aunt Sarah died Thanksgiving night.
Oh, I'm so sorry. What happened?
The car went over Lantano Bridge. It was horrible. She was supposed to get married today.
Oh, God, that's ironic. Beau Buchanan was talking about a wedding that he had planned this week, too.
Well, this Sarah is Beau Buchanan's fiance.
Oh, my. Oh, God, that's horrible. I should call Beau. Oh, God. What a horrible Thanksgiving this has been for everyone.
What, you didn't have a good time?
Oh, God, well, the weather was lousy. The airlines don't know the meaning of the word on time. I had a fight with a car rental agency. It was about as cheery as sitting in a dentist's chair. God, it's so horrible for Beau.
Mom, I'm really sorry that your holiday was so miserable.
Oh, you can make it up to me. You can come skiing with me this weekend in the Poconos.
I'm sorry, I can't. I got plans.
With your father and Sheila?
Yeah. Mm. We're going antiquing in New Hope.
Yeah, why is it that every time... Oh, never mind. As a famous physicist once said, you can't be in two places at once, so go. Have fun. If you see a mahogany nightstand, let me know.
I will. I have to make a phone call. I'll be right back, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Are you okay?
Oh, yeah, It's one of these headaches. It passes fairly quickly. It's really nothing. Thank you.
Oh, it's over to the glass.
Did I do that?
Yeah. Don't worry about it. I'll go get a broom.
Oh, my God. Sarah, where are you? Where did... Sarah? Where are you? Sarah? Oh. Sarah? Where did you go? Sarah, where are you?
Should look in on him later.
Sure. No. Oh, Sheila, I'm okay. Look, I want you to get a hold of Hank Gannon, okay? And you tell him I have to see him right now. Because I remember something about the accident, and he's got to start an investigation right now.
Okay, I'll tell him.
And Sheila, this is life or death. Because I could use company.
Sure, but whatever you want, you name it.
You know, you never know what you're capable of until it happens.
Yeah.
Do you?
No. Beau, are you, Beau, do you want to talk about some of the painful but practical matters? If not, say no, and we can talk about those arrangements later, okay?
God. What? No, I'm sorry. Andrew, look, I'm drugged, and I could hear you talking, and I thought I understood what you said. But then all of a sudden, there I am. I'm right back in the car with Sarah. We go over the rail, and we're in the water again.
Well, you can't blame yourself for that.
No, I did. You know, I thought I was careless. Maybe I lost control of the car or something. I didn't. All of a sudden, there's these lights. They're coming right at us. And I had to hit the guardrail, otherwise, you know, I would crash right into that car head on.
Because that's the kind of detail that the police need to know, then they can find out how this accident happened.
No, there was nothing accidental about this.
Oh, you said so yourself. A car wandered into your lane. You swerved out of the way.
Yeah, but what if that car was coming at us on purpose, you know? What if that car intended to force us right off the bridge?
Well, are you saying then you think that somebody was waiting for you, that this was some kind of an ambush at that exact time, at that exact spot?
Yeah, well, hey, it was no big secret. I was going to the airport, and I was going to pick up Sarah. Odds are I was going to go home on that road. You know, this is not the first time that somebody faked an accident so that they could capture Sarah. You know, it's like that plane crash. You know, that was the first time that she disappeared.
Well, listen to me now. There is a tragic mystery here that no one is ever going to find the answer to. The mystery is why you were spared, why Sarah wasn't. And I know how afraid and how alone you feel right now. I know how difficult it is to talk about things like Sarah's funeral, but I will
help you. You don't get it, do you, my friend? You know, why should we have a funeral? Sarah's not dead.
I'm shot. I'm tired of getting a runaround. I wish somebody could give me a straight answer. Your pop.
Where's Sheila Price? I asked Sheila to tell Hank Gannon that I wanted to see him right now.
She called him. He'll get here as soon as he can.
Well, what's taking so long? You want to help me out, Pa? Go and round up the DA.
Bo, you're absolutely right. You should talk to Hank. But I don't think he knows any more than we do right now. I spoke with the cops who got to the scene of the accident right after it happened. They said the only witness is a truck driver.
A truck driver?
Yes. It was a truck driver who pulled you and Sarah out of the river, but he didn't get to the bridge until you'd already gone through the railing, and he says he has no idea why you went through the railing.
Yeah, but a truck driver pulled us out?
Yes, you were unconscious.
Well, then, no, wait a minute. The truck driver, he's got to be in on this. So don't you get, this is a perfect setup. Look, the truck driver looks like he rescued us, but he's probably in cahoots with that same guy that was driving the car and headed right towards us. And then he passed her off to his accomplice, and then he hung around there with me, and he was probably walking around like he's some kind of a good Samaritan, you know. Meanwhile, this other guy's got Sarah, and he's like hours away. See, but where?
Johnny, do you remember when Megan died? Do you? Do you remember that I really could not accept the fact that she was gone? And I made everybody leave the room, and I locked myself in there with her, and I kept talking to her as if somehow that was going to keep her alive. Sweetheart, I know how you feel.
Sarah is still alive, though.
Oh, she's not. She's dead. She was killed in the crash.
Where's her body, then?
It's here in the hospital.
No,
we're going to take her to the funeral home this afternoon.
No, frickin' God, no. Go check around the right now, and you tell me if you can find Sarah's body. She's not here. They faked her death again. Don't you see? It was just like the last time when they faked that whole airplane crash. Don't you get it? We thought that she was dead then. See, but she was still alive, so why should we think she's dead now? What is it? What is wrong with you people? You look at me like I'm crazy or something. Something to me, huh? I can't do all this alone. I'm going to need some help if we're ever going to get Sarah back.
Oh, well, Sarah is not coming back.
Oh.
I know you've had this horrible dream before, but this is not a dream. This is the truth, son. You've got to face it. Sarah is dead.
No, no. See, that's exactly what we're supposed to think. Pa, don't you remember what happened last time? You people were all taken in by this thing when you thought that Sarah had died in that plane crash. Look, I'll admit, I almost believed it myself, but somewhere deep down inside me, I knew that Sarah was still alive, and in my heart, I knew she was going to come back to me. And you thought that I was crazy. But I was right, wasn't I?